how do we configure a web service proxy? And what are the mandatory objects we need in order to configure a web service proxy? See, web service proxy is one service which works on a WSDL-based configuration. That means whenever you have been given with a WSDL, only in that case you can make use of a web service proxy. In the other words, I can say web service proxy can handle only a SOAP-based message format. Okay, so if the backend team says that they are exposing their service over a SOAP, and if they give you the WSDL and XSD to be used, only in that case you are going to create a web service proxy. Okay, so in the meantime, I'll ping you a link which will give you a difference between these services. Okay, so you can just take a look into this blog as well. I'm just pinging in the chat. So now, if you want to create a web service proxy, just hit on this web service proxy icon on the control panel. So once you've done that, it will show you the existing objects. If there are any web service proxies that are already created, that will be visible here. Since we don't have anything, it is empty. So in order to create a new web service proxy service, just hit on add, followed by first it will ask you to give a name to your service, web service proxy name. So just give a name to your service. Let's say I'll choose it as global weather. This is my service name. Okay, global weather underscore WSP. Hit on, after giving the name, hit on create web service proxy button. You can see here. Just hit on that. The first step after you create or give a name to your service is to choose your WSDL file. So whatever the WSDL that has been shared to you in order to expose their service or the data power, so that particular WSDL associated with the service you have to choose. See, you can see an option called WSDL file URL. Over here you can see local. If you have directly uploaded to the local directory of the file management system, you can choose it from here. Since I have uploaded the file into my local, under that global weather, inside that I have the WSDL file, correct? So you can choose the path where you have uploaded the WSDL file. So if you have already uploaded the WSDL file into your file management, you can select it from the drop-down list. If not, you can hit on the upload button here as well, and you can upload the WSDL directly. So rather than uploading it to the file management and selecting it over here, you can directly upload it here. Automatically that will be saved to your file management as well. Both are same. Okay, so the first step in your web service proxy creation is to choose the WSDL file, followed by, see, there are various ways of using this WSDL. One is, as I said, your backend team will share the WSDL to you, so you are going to upload it to the file management and you are going to select it over here. In few cases where the backend team doesn't wish to share their WSDL and XSD to the external persons, they use something called WSRR. You can see here, add WSRR subscription. WSRR is nothing but WebSphere registry and repository. WebSphere registry and repository. Okay, which means we have, like how we have a data power team, there will be a team working on WSRR. Their work is to upload these WSDLs and XSDs and to maintain all these files. So it's an indirect way of using the WSDL and XSD at the data power end using this WSRR. See, when you have been given with the WSDL and XSD, what you can see, you can directly change anything with respect to your WSDL file, correct? But here, you are only accessing it from a different server in your DataPower appliance. You don't have a copy of the visual file being shared with you. It's an indirect way of accessing the visual and XSD through your WSR. So in your like project where they, if they use this WSR subscription, they will give you what should be the subscription name, what should be the object name, and what should be the namespace. So these details will be given to you. Accordingly, you will update it over here so that you can consume that visual and XSD. Okay. So either it might be locally, they might share you the file which you can upload to the file management and use it, or you can go through with this respect to this WSRR. Okay, so either it will be the same. So let's say for the timing, we'll choose this locally selecting the visual from our file management. So once after you select it, you can see there is a next button. Just hit on next. So once after you choose your visual file, it will ask you to choose your corresponding front side handlers. See, you can see here, local endpoint handler is nothing but your front side handler. Over here, if you see, this global weather service visual has three different ports. One is global weather SOAP 12, global weather SOAP, and global weather HTTP GET. So you have to correspondingly configure the front side handler. So if you have already created a front side handler, you can just select it from the drop down list. See, sample HTTP FSH, and hit on add button. You can see at the right hand side there is an add. Just hit on that. Similarly, either you can use the same front side handler for all the three ports, or you can use a different one. But usually we go with the same front side handler itself. I will choose the same front side handler over here. If you have not configured a front side handler, you can hit on the plus button over here and you can create a new front side handler here itself. See, what we are trying to do here now is we have already configured all these individual objects. We are just integrating that with respect to a service. If you directly want to start with a web service proxy creation, you can come to this web service proxy page and you can start creating one by hitting on the plus, and you can create the corresponding objects. So both are same. Okay, so the first step in WSP creation is to choose your visual file. The second step is, once after the visual is loaded, it will ask you to configure the front side handlers. So just configure this front side handlers and hit on next. Okay. So once you hit on next, the configuration what you did will be loaded here. You can see here, as part of this global weather underscore WSP, you are using global weather.visual, which is inside your global weather subdirectory, which is part of your local directory. And as part of this, you are using three front side handlers, and three, all of them are up and running. Clear? Visual selection and front side handler creation. This is the first step. And in your web service proxy, if you see, there are different tabs like visual files, SLM policy, services, policy, everything. So here, the three major tabs where we are going to do the configuration is, first is the visual files, where you will choose the visual and the front side handler. Next is proxy settings. You can see there is an option called proxy settings. Just hit on the proxy settings. So let me just save the configuration before it gets timeout. Okay, so now if you see, earlier we were in the visual files tab, now we came to proxy settings. over here in the proxy settings, you can see there is an option called type, where you have static from visual, static backend and dynamic backend. What is this a type means? See, as I said, your request will always go from consumer to DataPower and DataPower to the backend. Okay? Consumer to DataPower and DataPower to the backend or the service provider. So now, how do you want to connect from DataPower to your backend service? Okay, so when you choose it as static from WSDL, that means you are using the backend